Leonard Leslie, and today I'm going to discuss inrush current and DC to DC converters. On the board, I have a block diagram of a typical DC to DC converter system with a source bus shows the source impedance, and then followed by an EMI filter and a DC to DC converter supplying a load. The inrush current that occurs on the startup of a DC to DC converter system like this composed of two regions. The graph here shows there's an initial spike in current that's caused by the charging of the input capacitance in the DC to DC converter and any capacitance in the EMI filter. Now, this particular part of the charging waveform in some cases can be a problem for systems that have a fast input voltage rise time and also have a maximum inrush current spec for the system. So in those cases, the fast DIDT or DVDT of the input voltage and the low source impedance causes this current to rise very rapidly, can reach peaks many times higher than the typical full load running current, and that can cause EMI issues in a system. Now, the second region of the inrush current waveform is the charging of the output capacitance of the DC-to-DC converter and also any capacitance that's in the load. This is always well controlled when using VPT DC-to-DC converters because they have a soft start circuit that slowly ramps up the output voltage to control that charging of those output capacitors. Now, in systems where inrush current limiting is an issue and is required, VPT offers several products that can control inrush current. This DV704A is a 2-amp EMI filter with integrated inrush current limiting. DVMN28 is a 14-amp EMI filter with integrated inrush current limiting. And the VPT PCM is a preconditioning module that does not have an EMI filter but does offer inrush current limiting. The customer can also easily implement inrush current limiting with a series switch in line with the input. The switch can be either in the positive leg or in the ground leg, and basically the control circuit acts to slow down the voltage rise time to the input of the EMI filter and the DC to DC converter. This is basically what's implemented in these three products to limit inrush current. With the inrush current limiting circuit implemented, or with one of our products that control inrush current, your input current waveform is going to look like this. When the input switch is shut, the input capacitor charging waveform is going to be greatly reduced, and the DIDT of that waveform is going to be much lower. That will improve EMI performance, and also the peak of that current never exceeds the full load running current of the converter. And this concludes our discussion of inrush current DC to DC converters. Thank you.